out on the streets, bumped into my brother Ryan. You know what I'm saying? Ryan is moving up in the company. He don't work by my side. So he has time now to have some fucking pizza. I'm walking past a pizza shop. He has time. I don't have time to get pizza. Ryan, I didn't eat today.
I didn't even get to finish. I felt bad when I saw him. I said, damn, I got to get to work.
How you feeling, baby?
I feel blessed,
when y'all
man,
see Ryan, blessed. Make sure y'all know y'all see me, man. Yeah. Bringing on B back. It's already written. Bringing it back. World's going to be a better place in a little while. We have a lot of work to do. We have to assemble a team of the best and the brightest. We have to make sure that we're telling the truth, and that we're coming from a point of soul, you know? A lot of you don't know me. A lot of you guys don't really know of me musically. I've been blessed to do a lot of things, but that's the beauty about things. As you get older, you get to get introduced to all the fly shit that you've missed. So right now, I'm gonna play for y'all the first record I ever motherfucking produced when Teddy Riley didn't show up to the studio. What did I do? Did I complain? No. Did I get scared and nervous? Mm-mm. You know what I did? I'm a motherfucking hustler. I went in there, I put this You a Customer beat up underneath that shit, and I made that music that sounded like Harlem, you know, in the late 80s, early 90s. So, you can't know where you're going unless you know where you came from. Yeah, so this is the first record I ever produced. I wound up selling 2 million copies, and it made me a millionaire before there was social media. Back in the days, you know, when it was like hand-to-hand combat. You talking like you got to go in the store, talk about moving hard copies, baby.